Hello friends, today we'll solve about static indeterminacy for frames. Let us go with our 2D first, then we'll solve with our 3D. Now in my previous class, if you see, we have explained more problems about beams, even we have explained about trusses. Now we'll go about frames. So let us take an example. We'll take a best example. Why? Because in this example you have to know all the cases. So here I just took a frame. If you see here, so this is our frame we have. Now here I just wanted to even give you two hinges. So here we'll have one hinge, here we'll have even one hinge. So even we have two hinges over here. Now you can just see this frame. We have to calculate, if you see with this frame, we have to calculate static indeterminacy. We have to find it out. If you want to find out static indeterminacy, already in my previous class and 3 to 4 classes, if you see, I have given you an equation which is equal to alpha m plus r minus beta j plus gamma. Now I think already everyone, you know what is meant alpha, fine. Alpha value, even if you take, in my previous class I have explained you about here alpha. Alpha is nothing but the actions available in each and every member. So what will be the actions available? Frankly speaking, we'll be having only three actions. And if you talk about your alpha value, we'll be having three actions. We have axial force, we have shear force, we have bending moment. So these are the three values. So alpha value here, if you see, we'll have three. Alpha value here, if you take, we have got three. So alpha I can write as 3. Now let us take with our m. What is meant by an m? M is nothing but number of members. So if you see here, how many number of members we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27 and 28. So number of members, if you take, we have 28 members we have. Now r, what is meant by r? R is nothing but reaction. So if you see here, how many number of reactions will be there for your fixed one? For your fixed one, we'll be having 3. Again, this also fixed, we'll be having 3. So here if you see, we'll be having 2. So again, this is fixed, we'll be having 3. So if you count all the number of reactions, how many number of reactions we have? 3 plus 3, 6. 6 plus 3, 9. 9 plus 2, we have 11. So total number of reactions we have are 11. Now let us go with our beta. So what is our beta? Beta is nothing but available equilibrium equations at the joint, each and every joint. If you see, how many available, what will be, like, we are not telling that it will be there or not, but how many it will be there. So that is known as available number of equilibrium equations. So if you see, available number of equilibrium equations at each and every joint will be 3. One will be summation of x equal to 0, summation of y is equal to 0, and moment is equal to 0. So this will be equal to 3. Now what is our next one? J is nothing but the joint. How many number of joints we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and we have 20. So number of joints we have are 20 number of joints we have. Similarly, even if you go with your gamma, so gamma value, if you talk, how can you find out our gamma? Gamma, it comes whenever we have release, which is nothing but whenever we have hinge support. So even if you see here, we have two hinge supports. So let us talk about first hinge support here. So if you see this hinge support, as I have said you, alpha value, gamma value, if you want to calculate, which is equal to here m minus 1, which is equal to, m is nothing but number of members joined to that hinge. So we have number of members are 1 2 3 and 4. So 4 minus 1, which will be equal to 3. Similarly, gamma value here also, it will be equal to 3. So how many total number of gammas, if you add 3 plus 3, we have total is 6. So let us substitute in our equation. Si is equal to gamma, like alpha L, alpha m. So here if I'll write it, so Si is equal to alpha m plus r minus beta j plus gamma. Fine. So let us write it as alpha. Alpha value is equal to 3 into m value is 28 plus, we have r value is 11 minus, we have, how much is our beta value? Beta value is again 3 into j is 20 plus, this is again 6. Now if you solve 28 into 3 also, if you take, this is 84 plus 11 minus 20 into 3 is again 60 plus 6. So we have 95 plus we have 66, which is equal to 29. So if you have any doubts in this one, you can ask me. Thank you.